So this is the burial mask. Burial mask had its beginning as a prototype for a lip mechanism for an animatronic head to articulate the lips of a flexible skin and give a performance that would approximate talking. This is the mechanism. This is spring steel. There are cables that feed into it and around it and manipulate it. It's a prototype. Still is a prototype. I was trying things out, illustrating some concepts, things that worked well, things that could be improved upon. That is a prototype. After I did this prototype, I had the big idea of turning it into an art piece. It's actually been on display for years, at least 2 full years, sitting in a storefront, people walking in, turning it on, and listening to a song and dance routine, basically. There's a couple of ways of controlling it. The way I had it in the storefront, so people could play with it, was on a playback system, basically burned onto a CD in a modified CD player, and this is what people were treated to. Now I'm going to shut that off because I've heard that song hundreds of times over the years, and well, let's just say I'm a little sick of it. But I was playing around with this, set it up last night. This has been sitting in a box for a couple of years. It has not really had any maintenance since I brought it back from its excursion into the wilds of public life. It still holds up great. It needs a little bit of fine tuning. But I hooked up the system by which it is programmed and just played around, did a couple of quick little programs last night that kind of give a good idea of its range of movement. This is a simple program. This is done on the VSA system. VSA, it's a virtual system, virtual servo automation, and it's 20 years old. Still works fine. There are more up-to-date ways of doing it, I suppose, but this is still adequate for this sort of thing. It's slider bars, plays. This is the routine that I call sad. It's actually more surprise after I started playing with it even more, but it's just a demonstration of expressiveness. So here we go. And you can see that the lips, jaw, eyelids, and eye movement all happen in the brows. And I'm just going to hit it so that it cycles. And that was, I don't know, it didn't take long. It's been a long time since I played with this. And it didn't take long to get back into the groove of how to use this software. It's fairly simple. And we'll shut that off, and then this was another little thing, another little demonstration. Call this one Side Eye. Basically, it's, you know, kind of a sassy little look. And a little bit of lip movement as if it's talking. There's no audio for it. And it's just a couple of seconds. Zoom in. don't know, it's almost like Popeye, the way the lip goes. I got an asymmetrical movement going on. Just to give it some attitude. Now, one of the things that I've noticed is that there's a weird echo in the signal of the jaw. That bounce, bounce, bounce. That's not something I programmed in. And that's relatively new. I think that is just a symptom of how old the system is getting. The software, the VSA software is running. I think the software is fine as a demonstration for a pre-programmed performance. But it runs through a servo controller board called the Mini SSC. The Mini SSC has been around for a long time. And the two that I put in there 20 years ago are still working fine. But there are newer, more conveniently, more user-friendly boards out there. And I've picked one up, the Palulu Maestro Servo Controller Board. It basically allows interface between a computer system and the servos themselves. So that makes it easier to program, makes it easier to interface. You can control the maximum speed of the servos. You can control the range of the servos. Set it up so that whatever signal you end up sending to the servos cannot overdrive them beyond what the mechanical limits are. And that is sort of the next step.